देश खुद अपनी वैक्सीन बना रहा है, वो भी एक नहीं, दो दो मेड इन इंडिया वैक्सीन। भारत अनेकों देशों की मदद भी कर रहा है। जरा लोगों को विश्वास मिले ऐसी कुछ बात बताइए।
ये वैक्सीन लगाने से आप लोग बिल्कुल सुरक्षित रहोगे, किसी प्रकार का कोई डर आप लोग ना लाए कि वैक्सीन लगाने से हमें कोई इसका साइड इफेक्ट होगा।
I am perhaps one of the oldest person and I told my colleagues I'm the one who's going to take it first and you look at me and follow me.
Watching News Epicenter with me, Maria Shakil. In the war against the coronavirus, India is armed with two vaccines, Covaxin and Covishield, and the rollout is taking shape across the country. Inoculating most of the population is the only way to break the chain of transmission. Top doctors of this country have taken the jab, calling on citizens to repose faith in the scientists and doctors who have worked tirelessly to deliver us a vaccine in record time. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Chief Ministers and Members of Parliament above the age of 50 will receive the jab in the second round. And today, Prime Minister interacted with beneficiaries and vaccinators in his constituency of Varanasi, where they too highlighted that the vaccines are safe and a critical shield against the virus that has ravaged the world. The world is also looking to India for vaccines with these life-saving vials shipped to our neighbors and agreements with Saudi Arabia, South Africa, Morocco, Brazil, and other nations. However, vaccine hesitancy continues to persist. States like Tamil Nadu and Punjab have the lowest vaccine coverage in the country. While many opposition leaders have questioned the vaccine data, criticizing the Prime Minister for not being the first in line to take the jab. The concerns over the vaccines are driven by a few factors. Both vaccines are still undergoing trials. There have been over 600 adverse events post-inoculation. False rumors continue to swirl on social media and WhatsApp. The experts have asserted the vaccines are safe and effective, and the adverse events are normal for any rollout. The center is going on an overdrive to counter all doubts, launching multimedia campaigns, roping in influencers and big names to raise awareness. So what will it take to clear all doubts? 6 days after the rollout, over 10 lakh Indians have been vaccinated, and we as a nation have just started. So how can India boost confidence in the inoculation drive? I am being joined now by an eminent panelist here. Dr. Rahul Pandit is the director of critical care, Fortis Hospital, Mumbai, and is also the member of Maharashtra COVID Task Force. We also have on the show Anand Bhan. He is the global health ethics expert. We'll be joined by Tom Varakkan of the BJP and others as well. I'm going to begin with you, Anand Bhan. The Lancet has published this data, and they are saying that the study on 375 participants across the country showed that the doses were well tolerated and led to enhanced safety responses. Will this silence the skeptics now?
Sure. Thanks, Maria, for having me. So, today's publication is certainly a good step forward because, you know, a lot of the demand revolved around the lack of data in the public domain. But we have to remember that today's publication also is primarily from the phase one study, which looks at safety. So we have certainly now data in the public domain to tell us a little bit around safety. But the sample size is only around 350, as you rightly pointed out. So I think the issue with Covaxin was not necessarily around safety, but it is mostly around the lack of phase three data, which is again primarily focused on efficacy. So yes, this will help respond to some of the concerns. But I think the larger questions around why a decision was taken in the absence of efficacy data remain. In the interest of sort of moving this agenda forward around how we can enhance probably uptake of the vaccine. I think that transparency around the decisions and maybe more of a debate both at the national level and also at the local institutional level around the evidence part of the decision is important, because I think what we are also seeing now is a lot of eminence-based medicine, which is to say a lot of eminent doctors have come forward and volunteered. But clearly, you know, a lot of people are searching for the evidence. And,
yes, but Mr. Mahan, if people are talking through their own experience, say Dr. Guleria speaks about it. We had Dr. Devi Shetty on the show. You know, others have taken the jab. All of them are feeling fine. They're talking about their own experiences. Don't you think that's enough for people to have faith in it? Jo vishwas ki baat hai, how that vishwas will come in?
So I think that certainly will contribute, but we have to also remember that the first segment of the population which is getting the vaccine are health professionals, and health professionals are trained to be critical of data, right? So they are supposed to look at the data in detail, not just on the basis of what someone else, even a senior, is saying. Obviously, that is to be respected and listened to, but you have to respect the data more, you know? So the saying in science is, in God we trust, the rest have to present data. So if the data is in front of us, then the lesser the clamor, the lesser the disagreement, because the data will speak for itself if it's quality data.
Yes.
And the more we will see that happening, and this is the today's publication is one step in that direction, I think probably the concerns around the vaccine will be lesser. So yes, it's great that senior doctors are coming forward and talking about the fact that there's nothing to fear and this is generally a safe vaccine. That certainly will contribute, but will it be enough? I think, you know, we need more on the data side.
You're saying that there has to be a multi-pronged strategy here, not just leading by example. There have to be other data that has to be put out in the public domain. Dr. Pandit, since you are working on ground, you are interacting with, you know, the doctors and other healthcare professionals. What are the questions that should be addressed regarding efficacy that will counter this evident vaccine hesitancy?
Thank you very much for having me on the show. While the question remains to be answered about the efficacy, it is not the efficacy which has been questioned by the people on the ground. It is still the fear for their safety, the fear for their unknown complication which may happen, which is what is bothering most of the people who are actually having some amount of resistance in taking the vaccine. But I'll tell you, the situation is improving. I am having a lot of my colleagues now who are actually volunteering to go and cross and take the vaccine themselves. But yes, we would love to have more people actually volunteer across and take the vaccine. Initial steps, we took the vaccine as a part of task force members, and a lot of them followed us. As I said, a mentor doing it or a senior doing it makes a difference for doctors, definitely. We believe in our seniors and our mentors, so it actually leading by an example is a good way of sort of starting off. But it is also true that doctors have their own mind. They want their data to be read by themselves and understood by themselves before they will
so
actually
Dr.
believe
Pandit,
into it.
So, Dr. Pandit, you get a sense that because it is healthcare professionals who understand the issues much better than, say, a common man, that is the reason why they are being cautious. When it is rolled out for public at large, you will be seeing long queues.
That's right. I think it will be definitely better once it is rolled out to public at large. But this is what we are setting as an example right now. So if the medical professionals show hesitancy right now, and that becomes a big issue and is circulated widely across in the common people, then they will also show hesitancy. So it's important for us as medical professionals to lead by an example right currently. Okay. And then as the data comes in, be very transparent about the data and say that, look, the data is good. At least the safety is not a question at all. Okay. I don't think anybody is bothered about efficacy. Even a 50% efficacy, we were going to give the vaccine emergency use approval. That's what I believe was always talked about. So we definitely have more than 50% efficacy right now from whatever data is available for Covishield. Of course, Covaxin data is not completely available
right
now. So
we have two doctors on the show today. Both of them have taken the jab. Dr. Arvinder Singh Soin is the chairman at Liver Transplant and Regenerative Medicine at Medanta. Dr. Soin, thank you so much. You have taken the jab. It's about leading by example. We are seeing top doctors in the country take the jab. The question remains about hesitancy. How do you counter that?
I think I agree with a lot of what has already been said. And at the outset, you know, all the senior doctors, whoever was on the list for the first day, all of us took the jab. You know, the thing is that Rohit talked about reading evidence. Now, if you actually read and delve deep into it as a doctor, it is pretty clear that both Covishield and Covaxin are safe. Why do you think I and Dr. Trehan, Dr. Mehta, all the other senior doctors in our hospital actually went ahead and added? We've had 2,500 people at Medanta already received the vaccine, and the remaining 4,000 will get it over the next few days. I don't think we'll have more than 10% or 15% naysayers in our hospital. And I think part of it is because the seniors have actually put their money where their mouths are and, you know, set the ball rolling.
But
on
Dr.
the first
Swain,
day
what
and
are the
day.
Naysayers asking you? What are the Safai Karamcharis or those who have their names in the list coming and asking you about their doubts? What are their concerns?
Maria, if there are two adverse reactions, like somebody having a tightness in their chest, which is not related to the vaccine, it becomes like a million side effects by social media. You know, the misinformation carries across because the negatives are amplified much more than the positives on social media. So there is lack of information, there's ignorance, there is misinformation. It is largely a concern about safety, as has been said before. It's not the efficacy that people are worried about at this point in time. I mean, let's face it, what's the alternative? I mean, the naysayer, I would like to have a debate with any naysayer, a healthcare professional who reads papers, who reads scientific research. Tell me, what's the alternative? I mean, the other side is really dark.
Perhaps Anand Bhan will be able to respond.
A vaccine which is safe,
Anand Bhan, this is the final nail in the coffin, is being said, as the health minister pointed out. What really is the option if not getting India vaccinated?
So, again, let me clarify, I'm not a naysayer. I'm a big supporter of vaccines. I think what we are talking about here is if there are valid concerns, and these are the kind of concerns which have come through from resident doctors, etc., we have to listen to them and try to respond. Now, it's not the case that anyone who's expressing a concern about the vaccine is necessarily anti-vaccine, or I would suggest that we don't even characterize it as vaccine hesitancy. We have to look at this from a more nuanced perspective, which is to say that we're going through a situation where there's been a lot of expediting of processes, and there are bound to be questions. The way to respond to them is also about engaging on the concerns which are there. If those are around primarily safety, then let's engage on them around safety. We've not done great with the way we have responded to SAEs. If you look at the Covishield example from Chennai, the person who had the serious adverse event, irrespective of causality, I'm not here talking about whether it was linked to the vaccine or not, likely it might not have been linked. But the way that person's concerns were responded to by the company was really, really unfortunate. You know, the whole claim around filing a 500 crore suit against a vaccine participant. The way we've seen adverse events being responded to in Bhopal, I live in Bhopal, I've seen this happen in a trial site in Bhopal with gas tragedy survivors. It doesn't augur well for how this will be in the larger picture. If this is how we're going to respond on safety concerns.
So let's bring Tom Varadkan and Madhu Yakshi
well
Gaur
when we have large scale mode.
Yes,
so I'm
I
not
agree.
Going to say that I'm opposed to the vaccine, but my point is
address
if there are concerns,
the
let's listen to them, let's
yes,
have a clear
enough.
Process, let's
Tom
be transparent
Varadkan,
around it.
Why
that
should
build
opposition's
confidence.
Questions.
We cannot negate those away.
Yes. Why should opposition's concerns and questions be seen as them targeting the government or targeting the scientific community? Why shouldn't it be seen as their concerns trying to address the larger hesitancy and hence ensuring that the government strategies are better equipped, the government is better prepared when the rollout becomes more, you know, gains momentum?
Maria, there is a method in their madness. On every issue, be it the vaccine, be it the migrants, you name it, they have done it. They want to corner the government. Here is one occasion where we could all join hands. This is about the lives of our countrymen. Where is the difference? Whether you are a congressman or you're BJP or you're left or right, these are human lives. No government worth its salt would ever dare experiment with lives. And here is a party going out and asking us when is the vaccine coming in, when is the Prime Minister going to take the vaccine, and there is an SP Chief Minister who asks, well, that vaccine belongs to BJP, and there is another gentleman who stands up and says, well, you become
rhetorics
after
aside.
Using the vaccine.
Put the rhetorics and
is,
those
and
ideas of BJP vaccine
sentiment.
Aside, but there are certain questions that have been raised by, say, a Manish Tiwari, who has talked about data. greater transparency? Can that be addressed as not being anti-vaccine?
How much data can you provide, Mr. Manish Tiwari? Is he a doctor? Nor am I a doctor. But when experts on the panel, experts in the country...
Okay. So because the... Yes, please. Go ahead.
Manish Tiwari is not an expert on data. The experts are on the panel. They're speaking out. There are community of naysayers that will be... The pharmaceutical industry is fully charged up. And they will not let India establish itself in a way that we lead in a lot of fields.
Okay.
That is a huge problem.
Okay.
And this political party called the Congress Party, unfortunately, is playing with lives, playing with Indians.
Well,
India has woken up.
The paradox. Let's talk about the paradox here, Madhu. Let me just ask my question, Madhu. The paradox is that countries across the globe are asking us for access to the vaccines, while there are those within the country, particularly coming from the opposition parties, who are talking about other aspects, which is perhaps leading to misinformation and those who are becoming skeptics here.
Maria?
Is it cynicism?
In the beginning, good, you asked a question about Vishwas. Vishwas kaise banega? If Desh ki Pradhan Mantri, Sara Desh mein, Sansar mein, the presidents and prime ministers are the first one to took the shot, vaccine, to build the confidence among the people. Here, it's a funny to hear the former congressman and current BJP spokesperson. I will not come to later. Let me not even waste time on answering what he is talking. Let me not even come to you. The way you're questioning the party stand, it's a very unfortunate even to say that. Let me answer here. Who politicizing, Maria? Who raised this in Bihar election? It is the finance minister of the country made politicized, saying that the corona vaccine will be freely given to the every Bihari. Have they returned to the Bihar after the election? No. You are the one making politicizing it. Is it precaution is better than the cure? Ask any doctor. Anyone says that. What Congress is questioning, Maria? Right from Prime Minister, the Congress track record is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru ji to Indira ji, Rajiv ji to even Vajpayee ji during his time, or Manmohan Singh ji. The vaccines were developed during the Congress tenure. We respected the temper of scientific temper, always respected highest regard to the scientists who were politicized it. It is ICMR pressured Bharat Biotech to bring this vaccine by August 15th. Is this not a politicizing this? It's the questions of human life here. It's not politics. Why the Prime Minister? Yes, we respect for him. He comes on yoga, he comes on gig, releases video about his health. Why can't he take it?
Okay, so let's move away from politicians and go back to the doctors on the panel. Because we have two doctors here who have taken the jab in the last 6 days, Madhu. They are talking about their own experience and they are talking about the larger science here. Let's go back to them. Dr. Soin, let's look at certain data that is emerging. States like Tamil Nadu and Punjab have the lowest vaccine coverage in the country. Why is it so?
It can only be one explanation, and that is lack of information, ignorance on the part of people. And I don't want to make a political statement, but obviously misinformation is getting ahead of actual and factual information. So I think that if the doctors, the healthcare professionals, take it upon themselves to educate the public, to actually have meetings and then take the vaccination themselves and then have the others follow by example. Not just that, actually have sessions of discussion with senior leaders in the community who are not doctors and allay their fears. I think that's the way forward. So you have to respect people's opinions.
That people in your own hospital were raising questions largely on safety. They were not worried about the efficacy or the impact of this vaccine, whether it will generate the required immunity. It was about the reaction or adverse effect of the vaccine. Then how was the communication made? When the vaccine is given, is there a communication effort that is initiated to those who are taking the jab that these are probable impact of this vaccine that you can have in the next 24 to 48 hours?
It was very simple, Maria. You're quoting me partially. I also said that most of us are going to have the vaccine, right? I said that 2,500 of us have already had it, and the remaining 4,000 odd, we expect most of them to have it because most of them have registered and expressed their consent to actually come and have it. Hmm. In fact, we're actually doing a study on people who've had the vaccine and looking at antibodies after vaccination. And most of the hospital workers have actually registered for the study, which then obviously indirectly means that they're going to have the vaccine. Well, having said that, before the vaccine rollout happened, there were several statements and information leaflets that were issued, emailed to every single employee, and there were numbers given there for people to contact those experts and doctors if they had any misgivings, any questions, if somebody was, you know, for example, on aspirin, and if they had any doubts whether they should take it or not. So all these doubts were actually clarified before the vaccine rollout. And it's not a very difficult thing. It's not a very costly thing. You just have to get across to your community, in our case, I mean Medanta Hospital, and tell them what's going on, tell them the truth. And then after telling everyone all that, most of us came forward and had the vaccine. Hmm. And, you know, I must tell you from personal experience, after a couple of days of inconvenience, a little bit of fatigue and fever, I'm absolutely fine for the last 4 days.
So greater transparency in communicating that, Dr. Pandit?
Absolutely. I mean, you need to do that. That's what we have been doing. As Dr. Swain said, I had my jab on Saturday, and after, say, a day and a half of just being a little tired, feeling tired and a little bit of low-grade fever, we've been fine. And what I did immediately on Monday is I actually communicated via a Facebook live session with all the employees of my hospital and expressed what I went through in the last couple of days and how it is something which basically naturally is going to happen with every vaccine you take up. And there's nothing to be worried about. And that sort of brought up a lot of confidence. Not only that, we are trying to do such sessions even for common public in Marathi, in Hindi, and we're trying to publicize it across so that it sort of goes outside the media platforms as well. Of course, we are talking on media as well, but outside media platforms as well, we want to sort of tell people that this is something which is correct, this is something which is safe, and these effects which we are talking about, adverse effects, are actually not adverse effects. They are the reactions or the effects which are expected to come after you take any vaccine, and they would be harmless and disappear within a day and a half.
Okay, so let me give the final words to Anand Bhan. Anand Bhan, I agree with you that all those raising concerns cannot be bracketed as being anti-vaccine. What is it that the government can do vis-a-vis its communication strategy that will ensure that this percentage, which is roughly around 55 right now, goes up to 95 to 100?
Well, you know, very clearly that there is a lot which is going to improve. I think a lot of what we've seen over the last week or so is not necessarily just because people have concern due to vaccines. There were issues with COVID. You know, it's also the first time we are doing this large-scale adult immunization. People, you know, need some time to get settled into the idea of taking vaccines as an adult. Things will pick up. You know, we have role modeling from senior doctors like Dr. Pandit and Dr. Soin. I think if we have more transparency, more engagement at various levels, the government can play its role, senior doctors can play their role, institutions can play their role, just have open mechanisms for engaging on issues and concerns. And I think if, as people start seeing that other people are doing it, they will come forward. I don't see that as panning out as a major issue, but I don't think we can avoid the issue that there are concerns people have. Let's try to address them transparently, and I think that there will be pickup of interest in vaccination.
So greater transparency is what you're suggesting. Thank you so much for joining us, Dr. Soin, Dr. Pandit, Anand Bhan, Tom Vadakkan, and Madhu Yakshi Gowd. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts. Of course, the vaccination drive has begun. It's been 6 days, over 10 lakh Indians vaccinated already. It is yet to be rolled out for public at large. The second round begins only somewhere around March, when Prime Minister, the Chief Ministers of States above the age of 50 will be vaccinated. A story that will be tracked very closely here on CNN News 18. That's all from me. Thanks so much for watching.